Right, back up if you want to be in the shop.
Ah, that was hard enough. Oh, I'm on a slope. Right, okay, so today what we're going to do, or what I'm going to do, is show you how to make your own fly spray. Because fly spray, I don't know why, but it just seems to have got so expensive lately. I went into a tap shop the other day and it was actually £30, ow, just bit me, £30 for a tiny little bottle, and I think that's ridiculous. Here at Fairfield we have 7 horses in total, 6 of them are in our care, so that's a lot of fly spray at this time of year. So I'm going to show you a really simple basic recipe. It's cheap, it lasts, it works. I actually have another recipe for later in the year, which is more for, don't bite me, more for horse flies. I'll show you that one a bit later in the year when they all come out. But look, as you can see, these flies are everywhere and these horses are desperate to come in. So I'm gonna go bring them in, and then I'm gonna show you a really good recipe, also a cool new bottle that we managed to found. So yeah, okay, let's go. Okay, so here we go. Basically, this recipe is made up of 3 things. First of all, apple cider vinegar. I don't really have the measurements for any of this, so you're just gonna have to wing it. I also don't have anyone to record me doing it, so I'm gonna do my best. So, okay, the second ingredient is citronella oil. I get this from Amazon. Classy cool. What I'll do is I'll try and put a link in the bio, or whatever you call it, the description of where to get this stuff from. And then obviously your basic, any kind of washing up liquid. Doesn't have to be fairy liquid, can be anything. And I'm going to tell you why I put these things in, and yeah. Oh, the other thing you need is either a very basic household spray bottle. This had a kitchen cleaner in it. Just make sure it hasn't got any bleach in it or anything, because that can harm your ponies, and really give it a good rinse out. I rinse this out about 4 or 5 times, and make sure you rinse the spray out as well. So I'll show you how to put this together, but before I do that, this magical item was found in Lidl. It is a battery powered sprayer, and I'm going to show you how to use that in a minute, because it's actually really, really good. It's almost like you're spray painting your ponies when you do it. But I'll show you how to do that in a minute. So there you go. There is your 3 ingredients. I'm going to do my best to kind of film myself putting them in. Okay. Okay, right. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so this one that I made earlier, but we're not going to use this one. In fact, I can show you a bit later. I'm gonna make it up in this box here. So this was from Lidl. There we go, open that up like this, and it is basically battery powered, and you unscrew that and you put your battery in there, and I'll show you how that works later. So really simple. First of all, you get your citronella oil. Again, I'll put the link in the bio below. And you only really want to put a tiny drop of this in, especially at this time of the year when horse flies aren't really out. It literally only needs like a tiny bit. So I just put like that. That's it. Again, it's a very small amount. It's so strong, it goes really far. So there's not a lot of point in wasting it. And that is really good for keeping all the midges away. Then apple cider vinegar. I got this from just a tack shop. Any tack shop sells it. You can feed it to your horses. I can't remember why it's good to feed it to them, but anyway, flies hate it, so that's good. I put about, I probably put about 100ml of the apple cider vinegar in it. So I'm going to try and do this without spilling.
Here we go. Apple cider vinegar, about 100 mils. Like that. Again, this is really cheap. Next to nothing. So there we go. So now it's a mixture of apple cider vinegar and citronella. And finally, to finish it off, I'm going to put a little drop of fairy liquid in there, and all this does, it just helps bind all the ingredients together. So you do only put a drop in it. Again, if you know your horse is sensitive or gets allergic to anything, probably don't do it. But if your horse is fine, I mean, Allegro is really sensitive and he wears all this stuff and he's absolutely fine in it. So yeah, you just literally put little drop just like that, and that's it, and that is it. This binds it all together, and now what I'm going to do is fill this up to the top with water. And I don't know how much it works out for each of these in the spray bottle, but I can tell you it's a hell of a lot cheaper than buying fly spray from a tack shop. Sorry to all you tack shops out there, but you can do what you want. You can buy it from the tack shop, or you can make it yourself like we do here. Like I say, we have lots and lots of horses, so it would cost a fortune to keep buying fly spray. So there you go, three ingredients: citronella oil, fairy liquid, and apple cider vinegar. I'm gonna go and have a play with this now and show you how cool it is. Oh my God, I can't believe this has just happened. I've just been laughing to myself. Okay, so this bottle thing that I told you all to get because it was the most fantastic battery powered spray bottle in the world, I've just picked it up. I'm gonna put it on the floor. And look what's happened. It broke. Literally, the plastic is just, oh, look, it's broken. And it was so cool because look, all you have to do is hold this down and there you go, it sprays. It's really good. But it broke and I haven't even used it. Maybe there is a reason it was £2.50 from Lidl. I literally just walked over here to show you all how good this thing is and I picked it up and it snapped. Okay, so there you go. I'll flip this around. So I'm gonna finish the vlog there. Just stick to a basic everyday household free spray bottle. Even if you buy the £2.50 electric super battery powered bottle, apparently they break straight away. I honest to God, I haven't even used that for a day. Patrick bought that yesterday and it snapped straight away, so don't bother. It's not worth the £2.50. And for you gardeners out there, it's definitely not worth it for you because you'll be using it loads and loads. There you go. Zara's review on the Lidl spray bottle. It's rubbish. It broke. Anyway, you've had a good fly spray recipe, so yeah. Bye.